That's right, Graham. It is Love Your Pet Day today, and we're talking about loving your dogs. Because among companion animals, dogs are unmatched in their devotion, their loyalty, and friendship to humankind. And owning a dog is not just a privilege, it is a responsibility. These animals depend on us for, at minimum, food and shelter, and deserve much more. So today, since it is Love Your Pet Day, we look at responsible dog ownership and what owners need to consider before getting a dog. And we've got veterinary surgeon, Dr. Leandre van der Merwe, who's no stranger to our studios. She's here to tell us more. Leandre, good morning. Welcome to Expresso once again.
Good morning.
Good to have you back. That's a pleasure. I see that once again you have cast your spell on our lovely little doggies over there. They are just loving you.
That's why I'm falling asleep.
I know. He's taken ownership of you. So, Leandre, tell us, what does it mean, in short, to be a responsible dog owner?
Well, to me, it's two parts. Firstly, it's considering your pet's needs, being physical, nutritional, and emotional. Yeah. But also, there is another part to it, and that's taking responsibility for your pet's actions. Yeah. It's your responsibility to make sure that your pet doesn't become a danger. Mm-hmm. Or a nuisance to others in the society. Mm-hmm. And that's quite important as well. And sometimes that's missed. Yeah. It is a big responsibility, and it's something that you have to look at from puppyhood. Yeah. You have to raise your pet to be a acceptable citizen.
Yes. That's true. Now, I would love to get a pet. It's my dream to be able to get a dog. But let's say we work 15-hour days. How important is time? Because that's also something that I think people disregard is you need to be able to spend time with your pet as well, because that's what they need, right? Mm.
Definitely. I mean, you can work around it, especially these days. Yeah. There are a few puppy socialization classes and puppy daycare, which do provide the opportunity for you to work full time, take your pet to puppy daycare, and fetch them afterwards, and then spend quality time with him. It's not just about time, it's about quality time.
That's right.
And you really do build that bond by spending time with your animal and time doing things together, not necessarily just being there and sitting in front of the television. And, you know, of course, these two won't mind, but but some other dogs might, you know, want to rather play ball or walk. Yeah.
Talking about that quality time, how important is it to keep your dog active as well? Because that's what helps their development and growth too, right?
Activity, some form of activity is very important for dogs. It differs between breeds. Some dogs are fine with just a leisurely stroll, you know, around the block, but other dogs do need more. Yeah. And it's not just the physical exercise, it's that change of scenery, taking them outside, having them sniff, take in other, you know, senses with their eyes. Yeah. It's like reading the newspaper to them, you know, when they go outside, taking all of that information. And they actually can become tired of a relatively short walk just because of that information overload. Yeah. So that's quite important, you know, to give them that privilege every day, not being cooped up in a relatively small garden.
And another thing that's quite important is, like, just as a child needs medication that needs to be checked up and go for their annual checkups or how many ever they need, dogs also need regular vet visits. How important is that, and do people disregard that a lot?
People do disregard it, and it's extremely important, especially that three first inoculations that puppies need. It's very important that it protects them against five different diseases, of which the most important is parvo. It is a fatal disease. Yeah. So it's very important to protect your puppies against it. And after that, we require annual checkups with a vaccination and a rabies vaccination, which is, you know, by law, all dogs have to have their rabies vaccinations. Yeah. But that's an opportunity for you to get your dog checked out, ask all the questions you need, especially the first visit with the vet. That's where you start your relationship with your vet. You can ask him all the questions you need. Your vet should discuss nutrition with you, regular exercise, flea control, deworming. Yeah. You know, there's a lot of things that the vet can discuss with you. Yeah. And if they don't ask them, they're there for
That's
you.
That's what they're there for. Yeah.
Exactly. So it's really that first visit, and then stick to that date the vet gives you for that first three inoculations, and from then the yearly vaccinations.
Wonderful. Thank you, Leandre. That's why we're glad you're here, so that we can ask you all of these important questions. But thank you so much for being with us, talking about this very important topic of owning a dog and how to be a responsible dog owner. So we hope that you definitely enjoyed that topic. They are our best friends. We need to take care of them. It's not only a privilege, it is a responsibility. So we hope that this talk helped you a lot as well. We're about to head right outside on the balcony again because we're doing yoga this morning. And Kat, I'd like to see your moves.
Share the love with South Africa's most loved dog food, Bobtail, for strong South African dogs.